Welcome to Radio Frequency and Microwave Laboratory. This is Prashant. In this video, we are going to discuss about reflex mode characteristics of reflex klystron.
Now coming to the operational procedure. To perform any experiment, we require source with supply, a test bench and measuring devices. In this lab, we have measuring devices like SWR meter, CRO and ammeter. Who are for beginners, CRO and ammeter are the best option for take readouts. So, on power supply. First, we are going to on cooling fan, then measuring devices, then klystron power supply. By pressing power on button, power will be activated. After pressing HD mode, power goes upside. By using meter select switching, we can observe beam voltage, beam current and reflex voltages. Now, by selecting beam current mode, by varying beam voltage, we are going to set up to 20 milliamps of current. Then in modulation we have to keep AM mode, and at the time these two probes will be activated. It is frequency and it is amplitude. By varying these two probes into middle portion, we can observe readings on your output. Coming to reflex mode characteristics. In this experiment, we are going to keep beam current into 20 milliamps range and reflex voltage is at maximum position. To find reflex mode, we are going to vary reflex voltage from minus 275 to minus 18. Volts in a step of 5, and we have to take readings from ammeter. So now it is 275 volts and current is 786. When I am changing it into the 270, current is 705, and when it is 265, current is 550. When it is 260, current is 125. And when it is in 255, current is 008 microamps. When it is in 250, current is approximately equal to 0. And when it is 245, current is 0. When it comes to the 400, 220, 715. In this manner, we are going to take readouts of reflex voltage to the current. We have to plot a graph in between reflex voltage to the current. While we are doing this procedure, for each and every step, we need to find out frequency by using frequency meter. By taking this frequency readouts, we are going to get a plot in between reflex voltage to the frequency. While we are changing the reflex voltages, frequency is varying or not, we are going to check in this condition. At a certain period of time, we are not going to get any powers at output side. Like one mode to the another mode, a certain gap will be there. In that gap, we are not going to get any outputs. For future experiments, if we put into the that voltage range of reflex voltage, then we are not going to get any output on output side. To avoid this condition, we have to know modes of the reflex klystron.
Now coming to the graph. By taking linear graph, we are going to plot the values. After plotting the values in this manner, we will get results. Here it is off mode, and these are the modes: mode 1, mode 2, mode 3, mode 4. Like we will get up to 6 modes. It is input ripple voltage versus current obtained at ammeter, and it is the frequency response to the ripple voltage. This frequency may vary a little bit, like 1 gigahertz. Thanking you.